This is the ET5, and I have it all apart again, and we're going to look at the timing of these two gears for the operation of the cams, which operate the rockers for intake and exhaust. Sometimes the surface tension of the oil is enough to keep these followers from bouncing up and down freely, so I put just a little bit of mineral spirits on there to allow those to move with the cams. And the engine runs clockwise as viewed from this end. I have reinstalled the piston, and we are at top dead center, which is the end of the exhaust stroke and the beginning of the intake. And at top dead center, I've put a mark on the crankshaft with a Sharpie. That's just another reference. You want to look at these two followers. At this position, the piston is still on its upward travel for the exhaust stroke, and that follower is still holding the exhaust valve open. When we get to the top, then that follower goes down, and we're now opening the intake valve, and the piston is traveling downwards. And we want to use this position right here, right in the middle of it, where both of these are partially up. We're trying to use that to time this engine. There are no reference points on this thing. When we're at top dead center, the flats on the crankshaft are not at right angles to the crankcase. The flywheel that has the magnet in it, that set screw, goes into that flat. When we're on the compression stroke, when we come up on top dead center, the magnet is approaching the Hall effect sensor. And by the time this becomes straight up and down or at right angles to the crankcase, the engine should already have fired. We have two top dead centers. We have one right here at the end of the exhaust stroke, and we come around again, and this is at top of the compression stroke. The engine fires a little bit past top dead center. Then we're on the power stroke. If we want to retime this engine, about the only reference we have is when both of these followers are a little bit up, and this is at the top of its travel. For a reference, I took a Sharpie and I marked where that set screw is. And I reached in here with a Sharpie and I put a little mark on that gear. If the valves on your engine have become out of time, it pretty much has to be that this has come loose from the crankshaft or this axle has been removed for that gear and it has somehow jumped a tooth. These two screws are threaded into the crankcase. If you remove those, this will come off and that gear will be spinning free. It would be very tempting to loosen this set screw and spin this on the crankshaft until we got everything back in time. I know that we have two flats for the crankshaft. I doubt seriously that there's a flat for this set screw. I imagine it was when the engine was timed, they just cranked down on this until it embedded into the crankshaft. And that probably has thread locker on it. If at all possible, I would leave this alone. This gear has 12 teeth on it, and the gear with the cams has 24. So when you're timing that, if you don't know where you're at, your only reference is to turn it until those followers are right in the middle of, both of them are a little bit up, and then try to get that gear to engage with this one. And when you put the screws back in, see if that still looks about right. Then you have to put the head back on the engine and see if the valves are working correctly. And that's going to be a bit fiddly. You'll be doing this by trial and error. But that's the only reference that I can see is right here. If we look inside here, this cam is for the intake valve, and this one down here is for the exhaust valve. And they will be up here. So one cam will be here and one cam will be there. If both of these are up a little bit, then that cam, one cam is still touching this follower and the other cam is still touching that one. That's the only reference that I can see. This is a very small set screw. It's a 1.27 millimeter hex socket. This is the only wrench that I have that's that small. Let's see what happens. If I can even loosen it. I cannot loosen that. A lot of these set screws do not have a very close tolerance socket in there. And Bondus is a good Allen wrench. And that is stripping through on that socket. So I don't have anything to take that loose with, even if I wanted to. After you get everything back together, this is your mark on the crankshaft right here. And we're rocking back and forth on either side of top dead center, and these two valves are moving. So that's the end of the exhaust stroke and the beginning of the intake stroke. And if we come all the way around, then we're on compression. So hopefully, if you've gotten those gears timed correctly, the engine will run.